right, man. Go ahead, get your badges, people. I can't stress how important this is to, because I have my badges. Hall of Fame, everything. I even have gold, Tyler scores, silver, everything maxed out on my Pure Shark. So when I run across information like I did on today's video, it's always dope to me. I'm gonna give a huge shout out to my guys at NBA 2K Lab. This video is not sponsored, but they always coming through with the most lit info that you're like, how did you do that? Legit, I can do jump shot tests and it depends on feel, but when they do their tests with the modded controller, it's totally different because it reduces the user variable. The release is different every single time so they can get real numbers for stats. We're most definitely gonna have like a Mythbusters type series out this year. That's a fact though. By the way, if y'all new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. We're dropping heat 24/7, actually daily. I'm trying to do daily. This video, we're talking about specific badges. Now my guys at NBA 2K Lab may or may not have found out the effectiveness statistically of each badge. Now pretty much everybody knows if you shoot from the corner, your chances go up. Even if you don't have corner specialist as a badge, just shooting from the corner increases your chances of making a 3-point shot. We were trying to streak on the park earlier. My boy Vans lagged out. Well, he's like a 2-way rebounder. He's a big man with no 3-point shooting attributes. I kicked it to him in the corner. Tell me how he made the 3. Telling you, that corner is deadly. NBA 2K Lab is saying if you don't have the badge, assuming an 83-point shot, 4% are gonna be green with 37.5% make. And you slowly work your way up. 43.5% makes for bronze, 46% makes for silver, 51.5% makes for gold, and 58% for Hall of Fame. So if you're continuing to make new archetypes, you have to take this stuff into consideration. Because if you're creating blends of different archetypes, you'll never get to Hall of Fame. All right, I see a lot of stuff in my backyard all the time. I saw a legit straight up bird. I see tiny blue jays sometimes. This was like a massive bird. So back to what I was saying, when you get those Hall of Fame badges, game changer. I'm saying from bronze, it goes 9% green, corner specialist 23% green. And that's the only difference. And these tests were over the course of 200 shots on my career. The next one is probably my favorite because I think we could agree, right? Limitless range. It's the best badge in the game. All right, is there still debate over it? Like, you can make an argument for pick and roll maestro. Even hustle rebounder wouldn't make the list. It's really between pick and roll maestro, it turns a playmaker into a sharpshooter if you're coming off a screen, or limitless range because you can shoot from deadly distances with almost no penalty. So if you shoot with limitless again, this is assuming an 83-point shot, a 21% make without the bag. At bronze, you get 30%. Silver, you get 35%. Gold, you get 41%. And Hall of Fame, you get 49%. Which makes sense because I was watching a lot of Ruffles 4-point videos. And it'd be so many people that had the badge was at bronze for them or it didn't exist for them. And they were still hitting, and I know it wasn't like that last year. So definitely, if you don't have the badge, the percentages are better. It's still a reckless shot to take that no one would recommend. But in the case of the Ruffles, sometimes you don't have a chance. You're just throwing up shots. And so they're saying 21% even if you don't have the badge whatsoever. Now the distance they were doing their tests from weren't as far away from where you'd catch me doing the shots from. As a pure shot with Hall of Fame, I'm pulling from way deeper. And keep in mind, there's more variables. If you have a better release, the percentages go up. If you have a good cue and your consistent percentages go up. I mean, with a base number of 83-point shot and assuming the same release, numbers are pretty staggering. And I'm glad they did the sharpshooter badges first because those are the ones I'm most interested in. Because the next one's catch and shoot, and I know through experience, catch and shoot is a deadly bag. I can do the most average release. And you know, 50% miss, 50% break, it'll drop. The only problem again on catch and shoot is sometimes you'll catch me leaning with the shot, which is frustrating. So without catch and shoot, you get 4% green, 37.5% makes. With bronze, you get 18% green, 44% makes. Silver, you get 30% green, 49.5% makes. Gold is 39% green, 54.5% makes. If you can see the trend, it is massive when it comes to greening shots. Like almost astronomically. And last but not least, Hall of Fame is 48% green with 60% makes. So by far, if we're looking statistically, catch and shoot takes the cake. You're telling me you go from 4% green to almost 50 just from getting the Hall of Fame bag. And if you mix that in with Dimer, the percentages get even higher, which is a good transition because Dimer was the next one. No, Dimer is 4% green, 37.5% makes. Dimer at bronze is 46% makes. Silver is 52.5% makes. Gold is 55% makes. And Hall of Fame is 59.5. Are you telling me I can mix that in with catch and shoot? And then of course, limitless range. And then assume, this is assuming an 80, right? So if you're a sharpshooter, you indeed have a 99. So the numbers is gonna be even higher for you. If you watched my jump shot video I dropped the other day, you're using the A1 release. That means the number is even higher for you. And then you learned the cue because you watched my video and I said, stop focusing so much on the shot meter, focus on your cue. Oh, once again, man, the numbers just can be even higher than that. I'm telling you, it gets to the point where it's bordering like 90-95%. It's deadly. That's what I'm trying to say. Basically, I'm trying to say this. Sharpshooter is still, in my opinion, the best build in the game. I've been seeing a lot of animosity towards sharpshooters, man. It's not as much on YouTube, but more on like Twitter. There's been a lot of people on Twitter low-key with an inferiority complex, man. They've been just getting cheesed every time I bring up sharpshooters. Agent, sharpshooters are OP. Nah, you just don't know how to defend them. I'm sorry. That's all there is to it. You should be hugging a sharpshooter. You should just have him this tight with you all the time. The fact that you think it's okay to ever leave any inch of room is hilarious to me. And every possible situation, you should not denying the ball. I am gonna use an off-ball screen to get open. And when I don't do that, I'll try to cut to the rim, switch it up, come back out. Like, I'm gonna do so much different tricks to confuse you. I'm always trying to be uncomfortable. I'm trying to be unpredictable. And then you add that in with these percentages here. And then for whatever reason this year, the zigzag is the best move. Now, I would understand when people get mad about zigzag. I think it's annoying, it looks silly, but If you don't have 86 ball control and you don't have the speed boosting and those quick animations, zigzagging is literally the best way to get around. So you could be a sharpshooter that did the animation glitch to get elite animations before it got patched, and you would still resort to zigzagging if you wanted to cheese and win the game 100%. And low key, I might have found a way with my sharpshooter to shoot contested layups. I'm just saying I might have found a way. I might have found a few deadly releases since I even dropped the video a couple days ago. I've been playing a lot of Park. Man, so I'm just saying, like, I told y'all. So I'm gonna leave NBA 2K Labs link in the description. Use code AGENT if y'all want, because they have premium. Yo, they're so serious. They legit have premium info because this is kind of proprietary. No, like I hit them up and I'm like, yo, I would love to make videos on this type. And they're like, sure, agent. I'm not even getting paid for it. I'm just saying, if you play 2K and you're serious about it, why else would you not go there? So anybody wasting time on hotspots this year, you can just go to their website and see what I mean? I'm just saving time, that's all. I'm saving y'all time making these videos and they're saving me time uploading stuff to their website. Anyway, catch you guys later. If you enjoyed, drop a like, subscribe if you guys are new. I'm out. Peace.